Hello and welcome to episode 6 of Let's Play Civilization 6. I did play some turns after the last episode just to clean things up a bit, skip over some of the more boring bits, and just to look around. I noticed while I was looking around that I'm actually not that far away from a cultural victory. Very close. So I may try to aim for that, because I was thinking about maybe doing a space race or something. But space race in this game is very slow. I also found something interesting. If you recall, one of my spies, I think with the Greeks, was captured earlier. And you can actually trade your captured spies back, so I can go make a deal. Is it with them? Maybe not. Maybe it's with the Congolese. Okay, never mind. Let's check the Congo. Not them either. Indians. Thought I had seen the spy somewhere. I was pretty sure it was the Greeks. Oh, okay, it's not through here. Okay, I gotta go to the spy menu, and here I have a captured spy, and I can go ask for trade. So, what do they want? They want 20 gold for 13 turns. Let's haggle this down to 19. They want 1 gold for 30 turns? I think this might be a bug. I've heard about a bug before. We'll take it. We'll get our spy back. I'm not too keen about the open borders, but the other thing I noticed was that our war monger penalty has worn off against the Indian Empire and the Congolese. The Pericles doesn't like us. They're unfriendly, but they're not angry and denouncing us like the Chinese are. So that's an improvement. Not that I care too much, because I might be at war with the Chinese soon. So let's see here. Pamela, what do I want to do with her? See my spy operations. I have one in Athens. Okay, I'm gonna send her to the Congo. Let's travel to New City. Actually, before I do that, let's see what I want. Maybe the Indians? Or the Chinese? I am making a spy that I can send to the Chinese. Yeah, I'm one turn away. So I'm gonna send this to the Indians. Travel to New City. Okay.
Distracted from distraction by distraction.
Okay. Dorothy. Oh, that's our new spy. Okay, we're gonna send her to China. You know, I just finished? That's weird. I thought I just finished off social media. That's really strange. Yeah, I finished it. So we're doing globalization. Well, this is good. This is only a 16-turn build. And we can build it on water. That's a good one. Let's go for that. Hugh Teokali. Must build on lake, must be on a coast. Yeah, yeah, why not? And, okay, I'm gonna move this guy over here. There's some shipwrecks to explore. I'm gonna get the builder out. Let's build a zoo. Let's get the trade routes. Oh, we did get the oil, by the way, in the inter-turn, so that's good. Just seeing what else I can do here. I'm on future tech now, so I'm pretty much done the tech tree. I'm just gotta build the space race stuff and figure out how I'm gonna win. I think this game is pretty much won. It's just winding down, getting the mechanics right, understanding more of the mechanics. The cultural victory mechanics is kind of interesting. So your defense is basically your internal tourists, which is here. And a fraction of those tourists will be going outside your borders, right? So the more wonders other civilizations have, the more pull there is out of your empire. But because I have fairly good, if I use a tourism lens, I have fairly good amount of wonders. And these resorts actually pull people to visit. There's 8 here to this resort, and there's 10 and 6 here. So I'm going to try to build a resort here as well. Because I have, yeah, like I said, quite a few places for them to visit, I actually have fairly good internal tourism, so 329. And all I need to win is pull enough tourists to be one more than the internal tours of my closest competitor, which is Greece. So 321 plus 1 is 322, so that's the tourists that are visiting Greece internally, generated by the Greeks. And I have to pull in enough people, more people by 1, beat Greece by 1 from other countries, and if I can do that, I win. So I have to basically do more touristy stuff if I want to do the tourists, the cultural victory. And I think this is a good chance because, you know, I'm technically doing a space race. That's what I was thinking I was going to be doing. But because it's going to take a long time, I'm still building my spaceport here. I might as well try to aim for cultural and see that victory, because to be quite honest, cultural victory, I rarely see that victory condition. In Civ. I mean, I've played a few games, several games of cultural in Civ 5. But this was during the Gods and Kings expansion. I actually did not play as much on the Brave New World as a cultural victory. Okay, let's put a factory out. That factory is going to help boost this one too, so it's this one, they're just gonna boost each other in this core area here. It's gonna make it much more productive when we need to build the spaceship parts and stuff later on, I assume. China is definitely getting a little bit worried here, and I need to be building more military as well. I've been slacking a bit. I did get my new bombers. I got stealth technology, so I got these nice bombers, jet bombers, B-52s, I think. Or I don't know what they're called. Okay, I do not have nuclear weapons, though. Rocket artillery, so I have another one here. Oh, I cannot build seaside resort here. Why? It's on a hill. Yeah, it won't let me do it. Okay, back to square one. Here I'm researching Operation Ivy. Oh, I have a spy of theirs that I have captured. No. You're not getting that. I might take this. No. Here, what kind of luxuries? I wish I could check my luxuries access here. Can we do 11 gold? No, 10 gold. He's gonna be terrorizing us with that stupid spy again. I'll take it. Did I lose suzerain from what? Nanmadal. Let's get another, Oh, these observation balloons apparently increase range of my range unit, so I should build one of those. Gain resources. Oh, I captured another spy. Good.
Even though the future seems far away, it is actually beginning right now.
These are all more offensive oriented. Make one of that, I guess. Congo. Gonna go talk to him. Wait, did I just see a smiley face next to Gandhi? Oh, he's new Cappy, okay. Well, he likes us now, apparently. Our warmonger penalty is all gone. Good trade relations, same government, favorable trades to them. Yeah, well, I just gave him back your spy. Secondary agenda is supposed to be random, but I've seen more than one person say that his hidden agenda is new Cappy. I don't know if this is completely random. It seems very heavily weighted towards this, if I'm seeing this myself. Yeah, that's interesting. Okay, what do I... Ooh, 90% success. Steal some of his money here. Let's gain resources here. Okay. Is he crazy? We're gonna give him everything. Gold for turn. Okay. Let's get a another rocket artillery out. Yeah, these are supposed to increase the range of my artillery, so I'm going to move them. Oh, I can build a resort here. Let's do that. Pedro doesn't like us. Oh, wait, no, that was Tom Clancy. For some reason I read... I guess... Lost Suzerain and Valetid as well. That sucks. Gonna buy a archaeologist. Or not? I can't buy that? Or do I need to buy it from a city with a cultural district? Oh, that's weird. Oh, I can build a nuclear device now. Let me look up archaeologists. I'm still a little bit unsure why we can't build anymore. Oh, I need a museum. Maybe my museum is full. Yeah. Yeah, this one is full as well. So, since I'm, you know, swimming in money, I'm going to buy a seaport. Let's build an armory there. I have basically moved all my trade routes out of China, and now I have no trade routes with them anymore. $250 out of $320, the internal tourist drop. So we're pulling in more tourists, getting close. Tempting. Let's build some more military units. One thing I've noticed is there are no golden ages in this game. Okay, let's get another destroyer out here for you. before I set.
There is nothing like a dream to create the future. One day there will be no borders, no boundaries, no flags, and no countries. And the only passports will be the heart.
Like, I want to, go to war, but I'm really comfortable right now what I'm doing. I do like the fact that the modern the future tech is basically. Oh, I guess we research these again and keep researching the same things. Yeah, the future text will give you different quotes this time, not the same one. That got kind of stale after a while. Got an achievement off that. Okay. Choose a mission. I have two spies in Washington, don't I? Yeah. Okay.
Guess we'll build a nuclear device. Build another resort here. Killed two spies. One was captured, the other was, well, that's almost as much of a casus belli as it can be. I mean, I don't like this. Talk to the Chinese. There's no cause for war, for spying on me and getting caught. All I can do is ask them to promise not to spy on me. That's. And my warmonger penalties are pretty high if I were to declare war on them. Not a big fan of my options right now. Heavy or severe. Need them, but okay, I think we're running a bit long again today, so. After I complete the moves for this turn, I'm going to call it a day. And one turn for the modern armor, okay? Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time.